In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, we celebrate today the feast of Saint Bartholomew. As we continue our Christian life, let us all the more acknowledge the Lord who's continuously seeking out for us, finding us in our own ways, so that we can follow Him more closely. To prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries, let us acknowledge our sins and ask the Lord for pardon and strength. You raise the dead to life in the Spirit. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You bring pardon and peace to the sinner. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You intercede for us with your Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest.
And on earth, peace to people of goodwill.
We praise you, we bless you,
we adore you, we glorify you.
We give you thanks for your great glory.
Lord God, heavenly King,
O God, almighty Father,
Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son,
Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father,
have mercy on us.
For you alone are the Holy One,
you alone are the Lord,
you alone are the Most High Jesus Christ,
with the Holy Spirit,
in the glory of God the Father. Amen.
Amen. Let us pray. Strengthen in us, O Lord, the faith by which the blessed Apostle Bartholomew clung wholeheartedly to your Son, and grant that through the help of his prayers, your Church may become for all the nations the sacrament of salvation. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated.
Our reading from the book of Revelation. The angel spoke to me, saying, "Come here. I will show you the bride, the wife of the Lamb." He took me in spirit to a great high mountain and showed me the holy city, Jerusalem, coming down out of heaven from God. It gleamed with the splendor of God. Its radiance was like that of a precious stone, like jasper, clear as crystal. It had a massive high wall with 12 gates. 12 angels were stationed, and on which names were inscribed. The names of the 12 tribes of the children of Israel. There were 3 gates facing east, 3 north, 3 south, and 3 west. The wall of the city had 12 courses of stones as its foundation, and which were inscribed the 12 names of the 12 apostles of the Lamb. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Your friends make known, O Lord, the glorious splendor of your kingdom.
Your friends make known, O Lord, the glorious splendor of your kingdom.
Let all your works give you thanks, O Lord, and let your faithful ones bless you. Let them discourse of the glory of your kingdom and speak of your might.
Your friends make known, O Lord, the glorious splendor of your kingdom.
Making known to men your might and the glorious splendor of your kingdom. Your kingdom is a kingdom for all ages, and your dominion endures through all generations.
Your friends make known, O Lord, the glorious splendor of your kingdom.
The Lord is just in all his ways and holy in all his works. The Lord is near to all who call upon him, to all who call upon him in truth.
Your friends make known, O Lord, the glorious splendor of your kingdom. Please stand.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Philip found Nathanael and told him, "We have found the one about whom Moses wrote in the law, and also the prophets, Jesus, son of Joseph from Nazareth." But Nathanael said to him, "Can anything good come from Nazareth?" Philip said to him, "Come and see." Jesus saw Nathanael coming toward him and said to him, "Here is a true child of Israel. There is no duplicity in him." Nathanael said to him, "How do you know me?" Jesus answered and said, "Before Philip called you, I saw you under the fig tree." Nathanael answered him, "Rabbi, you are the Son of God. You are the King of Israel." Jesus answered and said to him, "Do you believe because I told you that I saw you under the fig tree? You will see greater things than this." And he said to him, "Amen, amen, I say to you, you will see heaven opened and the angels of God ascending and descending on the Son of Man." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
If we are to describe the encounter of Jesus and Bartholomew or Nathanael, this apostle cannot play hide and seek with Jesus. Hindi niya makuhang makipagtaguan kay Jesus. And we might sense that Bartholomew wants to work or wants to stay on the limelight para hindi siya makita o para hindi siya mahalata. But we are grateful for that fig tree where Jesus saw him. Sa akala niyang makakatago na siya o hindi siya makikita ni Jesus, indeed with the Lord, we cannot play hide and seek. It will always be an encounter or the experience of an apostle or someone called by God, as a priest, as a religious, wherever or who we are. We would always say to ourselves that I am unworthy, I am a sinner, I am incapacitated, I am nothing, I am insignificant. Things that will make ourselves or would draw us to hide ourselves para makatakas o makatago tayo sa Panginoon. But the Lord will continue to take notice of us even if we keep on hiding and hiding. Jesus will look after us even if we play hide and seek. A month ago, if you wish to remember a homily of Father Cali, he said, with the calling of the apostles, God knows exactly where to find us. Tinatago man natin ang ating sarili, hindi na tayo nagpapapansin, pero makikita at makikita pa din tayo ni Jesus. Pilit man tayong nagtatago, pero patuloy din tayong tututukan at tatawagin ng Diyos. If we are having alibis or second thoughts as we follow Jesus that seems to hide ourselves away from Jesus, to just stand on that or under that fig tree, do not worry. We cannot escape the eyes of Jesus. Ano mang tago po natin, nakikita pa din tayo ng Diyos. Tatawagin tayo ng Diyos para maging parte ng kanyang kwento. God calls us from the fig tree. Hindi tayo makakalampas sa tingin ni Jesus dahil sa anumang pagtago natin o pagtatago natin, siya namang patuloy na pagtingin ni Jesus sa atin.
Please stand.
As we honor the apostle who was a man incapable of deceit, let us come confidently to the Father, opening our hearts in prayer. For every petition we shall say, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the church may be open to the workings of the Spirit, especially in the movements which enrich the faith of God's people. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That government officials may deserve their honor and dignity by their honest and exemplary performance in office. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That there may be programs for the formation of young people. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the sick may find help in the ministry of the church. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the faithful departed may share in the heavenly glory. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
In silence, let us pray for our own intentions, for all the intentions offered in this Mass, and our prayers for one another. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Father, as these prayers come before you with the help of Saint Bartholomew, teach us to care for others and to trust in your providence. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please be seated.
Please stand.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy Church.
As we celebrate anew the feast day of Saint Bartholomew, O Lord, we pray that we may obtain your help through the intercession of the Apostle, in whose honor we bring you this sacrifice of praise, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For you have built your church to stand firm on apostolic foundations, to be a lasting sign of your holiness on earth, and offer all humanity your heavenly teaching. Therefore, now and for ages unending, with all the hosts of angels, we sing to you with all our hearts, crying out as we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Please kneel.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Please stand.
The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your Church, spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Jose, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, with Saint Bartholomew and all of the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
With longing for the coming of God's kingdom, let us offer the prayer Christ himself taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven,
hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Please kneel.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Please stand.
Let us pray. As we celebrate the feast day of the Blessed Apostle Bartholomew, we have received the pledge of eternal salvation, O Lord, and we pray that it may be of help to us, both now and for the life to come, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down on you and remain with you forever.
Amen.
Our celebration has been offered. Go forth in the peace and love of Christ.
Thanks be to God.